Time to talk movies. Thor's here. Hammer is out. And let's talk about a sequel.
All right. You know what? This is interesting because 300 Rise of an Empire actually takes place during the events of the first film from 2006 during Gerard Butler. And this time around, there's a lot of naval battles going on. We've got Greek General Themistocles facing off against Artemisia. She's the commander of the Persian Navy.
Try saying that 10 times fast.
Hello.
So in the cover of night, the palace was cleansed of all Xerxes' allies.
Vengeance. Yeah.
Well, I think I got my Halloween costume for 2014.
I need to say, you know who that guy is who plays Xerxes?
No.
That's Rodrigo Santoro, who played Carl in Love Actually, who Laura Linney had the crush on in her office.
No.
Yes, I know. Crazy. Okay, this movie is visually stunning. I was not looking forward to it. I went in with very low expectations. Part of the reason that it's good is the visual effects are so wonderful that it's hard to really capture water and make it look realistic when you're dealing with CGI, but they do it beautifully here. However, the overuse of slow-mo really got to me after a while. And if you saw the first 300, they overdo that whole Matrix effect. So that was a bit distracting. But it's got a great sense of flow, fast-paced action scenes, and there's just a rhythm to it that really keeps you engaged the whole time. Eva Green there from Casino Royale, scene stealer. She is incredible in this role. And also Lena Headey, who plays Cersei Lannister in Game of Thrones, she's wonderful in the film, so it's got two very strong female roles.
And with the parallel narrative for not the traditional formula for a sequel, that sounds interesting. Is this better than the original?
I thought it was better. The actors filled the roles very well. The lead is Sullivan Stapleton. He's an Aussie. A simple but engaging story. The drawbacks, though, it's somewhat jingoistic. I mean, you've got the Greeks versus the Persians, which is essentially Caucasians versus Middle Eastern, so that's a little bit unsettling. The script does resemble a comic book, but I was engaged the whole time, and it's got some wonderful eye-popping action.
How many hammers?
3 out of 5.
All right, 3 out of 5 to get us started. Now, if you want to switch gears and go with comedy, you've got a great choice for us.
Yeah, Steve Coogan reprising his role as the egotistical DJ Alan Partridge, and this time around he's working at a radio station facing corporate cutbacks, and one of his co-workers, played by Cole Meany, gets laid off. He takes the whole staff hostage. Coogan is a comic force in this movie. Countless one-liners, so funny, so witty, but it never quite has the kinetic energy of the TV show that you know, this character is based on, the radio shows as well. And not every joke hits the mark. There's a couple of physical humor gags that don't always work for me, but it's got a very talented cast with some wonderful British charm, and with all the silly comedies out there and the rom-coms these days, this is very refreshing and very authentically UK, even though the story was somewhat formulaic.
Lay it down on us. How many hammers?
It's a 3-hammer split this week, people.
Okay, nice one. All right, 2 for 2 right there. Let's check in with Don over in the Live Eye.